Welcome at Autonotizen International, the English language version of German YouTube channel Autonotizen. This explains my weird German accent. And again, I brought a German car that I can present to you. This is again the all new Volkswagen Multivan, but today we've got a special version here for you to see. Electric sliding doors are part of the full options specification of this test car, and so I welcome you in the spacious interior of the Multivan with the longer body. We've got a 7-seat configuration, that means 3 individual seats in the third row. I can fold this seat down, as it can be done with any individual seat that you have a better view. Those 3 seats, they are all adjustable in length. They all have these ISOFIX cassettes for kids seats. And here in the test car, the 2 seats in the second row are even heatable. We've got electricity in the floor, so these seats are heatable. Despite the fact that you can adjust them and you can even remove the seats if you want, and you can place them wherever you want, even in your garage if you need more space for goods and luggage. So the seat is back in again. Let me step out and explain the new Multivan briefly to you. It's not really the successor of the T6 or T6.1, because the established Multivan is still in production as an all-wheel drive version and of course as the California camper van. The face looks quite different than the one of the T6 or T6.1. We've got Matrix LED headlamps here. Volkswagen is calling them IQ Light. And under the bonnet, we've got a choice of petrol engines, 2 petrol engines and 1 electrified plug-in hybrid that comes with a system power output of 218 horsepower. The base model we already presented to you. It's got a 1.5-liter 4-cylinder TSI with 100 kilowatts, or 136 horsepower. And here we've got the current top version. It's a 2.0 TSI petrol engine that delivers up to 204 horsepower. A diesel will only come later in the year 2022. The car we have here has almost all options of the price list, including the bi-color blue and white finish. That looks very Bavarian, maybe. Some people like it, some don't. Let me know in the comments what you think about that color combination. The car itself has grown in length compared to the predecessor, but it's less high. The height is 1 meter and 91 centimeters. That means it can more or less easily fit into the majority of parking garages and parking lots. Here we've got the longer version. The wheelbase is always the same, 3 meters and 12 centimeters, and the additional 20 centimeters, bringing the full length or the total length of that car to 5 meters and 17 centimeters, is done here at the rear. That means the seating space is the same in both cars, the normal and the longer version, but there's more space for luggage in the very back. If you remove all the seats, all the 5 seats here in the back, you can load up to slightly less than 4,100 liters of luggage into the Multivan. We won't do that now. Instead, I will have a look into the cockpit, and I hope you will join me. Here in the top spec car, we have optional seats that are heated, ventilated, electrically adjustable, and the driver's seat comes with a massage function as well. In Germany, they cost 4,000 euros, including the 2-color leather upholstery. It's quite expensive indeed. We've got a center console for the first time in the Multivan, and that is removable. You can push it backwards. And for the rear seats, I forgot to show that, for the rear seats, you can pull it out and then you have a table for the guests in the second row. Don't do that here in the front while driving. I just wanted to show it to you. There's no gear shifter here in the middle. That means a lot of space because we've got a shift by wire, double clutch transmission, and here in the center on in the cockpit, you can use this knob for to set the driving direction. The cockpit architecture says, "Hello, Golf." The MQB electric platform is taken over here by Volkswagen commercial vehicles for the multivan as well. That means we've got a 10-inch display here as a standard equipment, and there are three different versions available. You can opt for sat-nav as a second option that can also be bought in-car as an over-the-air option. And here we've got the full-spec version with the Discover Pro called system, including the built-in sat navigation and other stuff. This is how the map looks like. We've got App Connect as standard, Apple CarPlay and Android Auto. So it's all accessible via a touchscreen. You can configure the home screen and so on. And here we've got all apps available. You can, if you freak out on the weekend and need a rest on Sunday, play with the colors, calm colors, cold colors, warm colors, whatever. Seat heating is accessible via the touchscreen. Then the climate system starts, or the touchscreen for the climate control, that can also be accessed by this button here. But if you want to adjust the temperature, for example, or the volume of the audio system, you need to use the slider, and that's not very easy to use while driving. That's still a disadvantage. Also, the instruments are full digital. You can change the layout by the view button of the multifunction steering wheel. That's all more or less common knowledge these days here with Volkswagen cars. And then you can also adjust, for example, what's shown here on the left side or right side of the instruments, whether it's driving assistance or the trip computer and so on. So all doable here. A head-up display comes as an option as well that projects the information directly on the windscreen. And here in the test car we've got a Harman Kardon sound system. That means there's no storage compartment here, but a large center speaker. We won't listen to the sound of the sound system now, but to the sound of the four-cylinder engine. I press the start button and we start our test drive. The new multivan is developed as a pure passenger car. That means the full suspension is different to the one of the predecessor, or the still built T6. There's no light commercial vehicle version that needs to carry a lot of load. So more comfort. You see that in the picture of the camera at the moment already. The camera guy is sitting in the third row, and it's more comfortable, especially with the DCC coiled suspension with the adaptive dampers. But also we tried the multivan live with the standard suspension in the other video, and also this car was quite comfortable. The 2.0 TSI delivers a maximum torque of 320 newton meters. That means the car is quite agile despite the size and the weight, and it even reaches a top speed of 200 kilometers per hour on the German Autobahn. We tried that out, and it really drives that fast. The fuel consumption in the daily driving routine is about a bit more than 10 liters per 100 kilometers. Of course, that's a lot of fuel, but again, considering the size of the car, it's not too much. And it proves that the 2.0 TSI, more or less similar fuel efficient as the 1.5, because the larger, the more powerful engine is, it's not that hard pushed in the big car. So if you drive long distances, if you don't want to go for the diesel, or if you don't want or can't wait for the diesel to arrive, then in my opinion, the 2.0 TSI is the better choice compared to the 1.5 engine. first class traveling in the new multivan that comes with a first class ticket price, especially in that car as we have it here. The price of this fully spec'd long version multivan is more than 86,000 euros in Germany. That's a lot of money, of course. And it's the same price level as the Mercedes-Benz V-Class and the predecessor. However, we have a lot of high-tech options now, the Matrix LED lights, for example, and the travel assist for automated driving while traveling. Thanks for watching. This was our first impression, or the second impression, of the new multivan. Maybe you've seen the other video of the short version with the live spec level. Thanks for watching again, and thanks to Andreas, the guy behind the camera, and see you next time here at Autonotizen International. Bye bye.